A warm welcome to you and a heartfelt namaste. I, Anuradha, would like to thank all of you for liking and subscribing to both my channels, YouTube and Spotify. If you haven't subscribed to the Spotify channel, please do so that you can listen to all the videos at one go, anytime, anywhere. Today, we are going to talk on Ketu. As one of our attendees of retrograde webinar had requested that we shed some light on Ketu. We have been working on Ketu through the houses, and we have covered Ketu through 1 to 7 houses. If you want to see that video, you can also do that. We have also made videos on Rahu through all the houses and a video on Rahu as to which area of life it causes problem for you. Today, we are going to talk about Ketu in general, about its nakshatras and what it has to say in store for us. As a very senior astrologer puts in, that wherever Ketu sits, it talks about your inlet of karma. A planet that is bringing in an inlet of karma for us definitely suggests that it is something, Ketu is something that we have worked on a number of lifetimes and got it in this lifetime in a particular position, particular sign, particular house, nakshatra, so that we can accomplished there. But it also has a stool. If you understand this carefully, you would know that something that we've been doing from past lives is something that we are very good at, something that we have been able to make certain inroads up to a certain level. So if you have an habit which you have been doing for a pretty long time, don't you think it becomes a very goes into the grain of your fabric, and it you become very staunch about it, you become very particular about it. You don't want to change that habit, you revolve a lot of things around that. When you don't want to change, you can have problems, because we know that one constant thing in this universe is change. So wherever Ketu sits for us, it also makes us aware that we need to change certain aspects of those things. They have been very much constant in our life. And when we start changing those things, the number of things, the dynamism of the chart is also likely to change. And if you don't change, because of its placement, because in certain house, in a certain nakshatra, in a certain sign, there could be certain issues that could be very strong in our lives. So what could it be? When Ketu is in the first house, it says that you have certain habits, you have certain way of doing things for yourself that can be very fixed, and you are not willing to change in your life on those principles, which definitely, as per what we will have seen in its counterpart in Rahu in the seventh house, could be that if we are not changing and we are not accommodating others in our lives, then it could lead to marital issues. For more on this, you could always see the problematic zones that Rahu creates or represents in your life. So now, if Ketu is in your second house, so that means there are certain modalities in your life that you need to change. You need to be probably less stubborn, especially if this Ketu happens to be in a fixed sign or nakshatras like Jyeshtha, Rohini. Because just for example, when Ketu was in the 10th house for Henry Ford, who was the one who had created the Ford machines and the Ford cars and the Ford company, because of his certain ideas in business, his business flourished because it was in Rohini Nakshatra and Ketu. But as he became very adamant about his way of conducting the business, it also led him to near bankruptcy, and it was his grandson who came and reprived the company. So the examples can be very many. We need to know, as I told you, the 10th house Ketu can produce such a results. When the Ketu is in the 12th house, in that case, it can so happen that you could have a wanderlust. It could also show that you would be giving so much that it could be creating a deficit in your own pockets. Ati sarvatra varjate. Excesses are always, you're always cautioned against excesses. Again, If Ketu happens to be in your fifth house, then your children could be very adamant about the way they behave, or you could be very adamant about doing your puja in a certain time, certain place, at a certain, in a certain manner, which again can disrupt your educational life, your family life, and many other things. So you're not willing to accommodate, or your elders could be very strict in their ways. If Ketu happens to be in the second house for you, you could be a traditionalist, not wanting to change your methods of learning or earning. And that could pose a problem to you, because in the dynamic world, earnings and the methods has to undergo a change. Similarly, Ketu in the third house, it gives you a set of friends that could you do not want to change, or ideas that you don't want to revolve around. And that could lead you to a lot of problems. Ketu in the ninth house for you could again make you a traditionalist. Your guru could be like that, or your learnings could be so strict and so fundamental that could give rise to a number of issues in life for you. If Ketu happens to be in your seventh house, your spouse can also show these traits. But it could also happen that you could be very fixed on your idea of how you would want a spouse or what kind of spouse you want. And that could lead to certain dissatisfaction in married life for you. If Ketu happens to be in your seventh house, it could also mean that there's certain kind of level that you want in life, or the way you want to stand up, project yourself in front of society could be different from what people would be expecting. And that clash between your own thought process or your own perception and that of the people could lead to a lot of problems in your life. We need to understand that Ketu is also very strong on change if it's in your Lagna. So let's just take up the Ketu Nakshatras here and see what these Ketu Nakshatras tell us very, very briefly. Ketu Nakshatra, to begin with, Ashwini. Ashwini is a nakshatra, again, very resistant to change. We know it's swift. We know it's fast. All those things said and done, we know that it comes to everybody's aid very fast. But you would also, on close examination, realize that this is a nakshatra which is very prone to procrastination. You just simply push away the things that you don't want to learn or you don't want to do to at the back of your mind, knowing that you have to, at one time you should, but you really don't want to change. And that, again, as I say, can cause a lot of problems. Magha Nakshatra is a nakshatra which is very traditional in its views. It is very traditional in the way it behaves. And it is also a nakshatra that would be willing to do a lot for others, conditional to the fact that you receive a lot of respect, you receive honor. It is not always possible for people to honor you and receive you at the moment that you wanted to. Probably on retrospect, as they realize that your value in society, they will be doing that. But for not being respected, for not being cared for, you could not be doing your full, and you would not be doing what you should. That again can get you in problems in future lifetimes also. And in this lifetime, definitely. There's only one Ketu Nakshatra that makes you realize that if you do not change, you will break. We always have this, we've always been taught that if you don't bend, you break. And that is the reason why the oak tree in the best of the winds falls down, but the grass blade keeps moving because it knows how to bend. The oak tree does not know how to bend. So this Ketu Nakshatra of Mula tells you that the person who knows how to bend, person who knows how to adjust, and with its symbol of roots, roots that penetrate the ground only because they can move into areas where there are gaps and they know how to bend and know how to make their way through to the bottom where they want to. So the lesson that we need to understand from wherever Ketu is sitting, whichever nakshatra it is sitting, it can tell us that you have been a little too rigid about the principles of that nakshatra and you need to change somewhere along the line to bring about a dynamism in your chart and to get not just your Ketu, but also your Rahu rolling in that direction. If we can understand this fundamental point about Ketu, a lot of problems in life would really see their way out. till we meet with you again, don't forget to write in your comments. Don't forget to subscribe, like our channel. Thank you so much.
Please hit the bell icon for fresh updates. Don't forget to like, share, and comment on the videos, and please subscribe